Good afternoon. Welcome to First Presbyterian Church. We're glad that you are here to share with the first of our monthly recital series this year. I'm Clint Talbert. I'm one of the pastors here. And I'm really glad to welcome George Blackney, who will be performing in just a moment. George is a familiar face to those of us who worship here. Whenever our organist cannot be with us, George is our first call and is always very gracious if he can to serve us in Wayne's absence. George is going to offer a program he entitled Eclectricity, which was a new word to me. It's because it's probably not actually a word. It's two words put together, the word eclectic and the word electricity. So the songs that you're going to hear will be introduced with short poetic quips, and George will offer some additional information from time to time as he does that. Look for a pedal solo in one of them, and near the end, get ready to participate there, because there'll be a little bit of audience participation. A few things before we begin our time. Again, remember, this is a monthly recital series. In the program, you will see the dates that are upcoming in future months. We hope that you'll set those aside on your calendar and prepare to join us and bring a friend along with you. Outside is a table. There is a sign-up list there. If you'd like to give us your email address, we will communicate with you about future recitals. We do the best we can to communicate, but sometimes things change. And if you're on our email list, you will certainly hear directly from us if there are any changes in future programs. There's also on that table information about the history of our organ and how many pipes there are and those types of things that you might be interested in. Finally, before I pray, let me just remind you to silence your cell phone if you haven't already done that. Even if you think you have, you might check it one last time. You don't want to be that person where it goes off. And then also, please know that after the recital, there is a space prepared downstairs with coffee and cookies. It's a place where you can simply linger and enjoy fellowship with one another. Before I invite George forward, allow me to pray as we begin. Well, Lord God, we do thank you for this day that you've made. We thank you for the gift of music. We thank you for the blessing that we have been invited into, to listen, to hear, to enjoy, and to give thanks to you for all that is life. We give thanks for George especially. Pray that you would bless this performance and enable him to share the gift you have given him with us. It's in your name, Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen. Let's welcome George Blackney.
And first on our chart is Gerald Peterson's The Joyous Heart. Enjoy.
Thank you.
It is a sunny spring day in the year 1708 at Dornheim, Germany, as Johann Sebastian Bach and spouse Maria Barbara do not tarry to walk back to the church where they did marry. 6 months have passed since the ceremony, when without acrimony, they did exchange their vows, which were solemnized by a friend, one Johann Stauber. Today is Stauber's turn to marry, and the box carry a gift, a wedding cantata to be performed entitled Der Herr denkt an uns, the Lord is mindful of us. We will hear the opening orchestral sinfonia to this cantata arranged for organ, after which, for an added treat, Bach invites us all to take flight with him inside one of his preludes and fugues in C minor, flight number 459. But first, the wedding sinfonia.
Thank you.
for variations on Freudig Sero Meine Seele. I'm here to share with you that when translated means, rejoice heartily, O my soul. These variations are sent to us by Denis Bédard, organist and composer from Canada afar. The basic tune is found in our hymnals with several different texts, to the delight of our congregations who sing out their best. But for today, just sit back and relax with listening peaked, as the music indeed tells us what the words speak.
Thank you.
Now for a real change of pace. Rhosymedre is a village in northeast Wales which found its good cheer when the vicar of the church, one John David Williams, composed his most famous hymn tune, which he named after the town, Rhosymedre. This captivating lullaby-like melody quickly spread as a warm blanket over the hearts of the British folk, from the humblest towns all the way to Buckingham's gowns, where it most recently has been heard at royal weddings and memorial services. The Englishman Ray Vaughan Williams sends us his take on Rhosymedre, which complements the tune even better.
Thank you.
Our next selection is given with the following suggestion: that those with hearing assistance may want to protect your ears, as the composer Edward Broughton is Shirley Shouten with his contribution of Raise the Sound of Praise. Trois et quis, three pieces gathered to make a musical suite and meant to be played by the organist's feet. The first movement begins with a growling, snoring, sleepy introduction, and it's followed by a lookout below, fiery allegro. Then comes the intermezzo with its three beats per measure, being meant for quiet listening and ruminating, but don't fall asleep, as the third movement is a gallop. Trois et quis for solo pedal board by Denis Bédard.
Thank you.
John Philip Sousa composed 136 marches, and some of them he was pretty sly, as in the Revival March, which quotes the hymn in the Sweet By and By. So it's your turn now to sing. I'd like to practice with you the music you have before you, and that comes halfway through the March, And you may be wondering, well, when are we supposed to sing? Well, I'm going to stop the music briefly and go, one, two, sing. Okay? So, let's practice that now. You know it already. Here we go.
There's a land where the thank you.
very much for coming. There's friends here from Emmanuel Lutheran in South Toledo, and I don't know where the rest of you are from, but I hope you're from here and maybe some other churches. So God bless you all.